Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to 2020's That's Entertainment, sort of, as we bring you the Tiger Chorale that would have been performing That's Entertainment a week ago tonight would have been the finale. Is that, am I right on that, on the date? Would have been last Thursday and Friday? Yes?
I think so. It's got to be close.
Got to be close? Okay. I think I looked the date up and it was last Thursday. Would have been last Thursday and Friday. So we're going to perform some. I'm not, but we're going to have some performances from Tiger Crown and hear from you guys as well. Let's start with the two seniors or three seniors with us. Who's your seniors? Raise your hand. Okay, two of you. Anna and Jake, let's start with you guys. It's been a weird year, to say the least. I'm sure you've talked about it more than you want to, but I'm going to ask you to talk about it again. Anna, I guess, when you find out that school's not going to get back into session and that all this work you guys have been putting in is not going to happen on stage, what goes through your mind first?
Well, at first, it was really shocking. I didn't really know how to respond. I didn't think that was going to happen. I honestly thought maybe we'd get another week off, you know, a second week of spring break, but I had no idea that I walked in and the last time and didn't even know it. So that's been really hard. It's been kind of surreal. I didn't feel like it was real until it actually started happening, but it's been really hard. But I feel like if a class had to go through it, our class would be the one that could get through it. So
well put. It is tough. Jake, same type of thoughts, I assume.
Yeah, it was just crazy at first, but I think there's been a lot of good come from it, and it's helped a lot of people in different ways. I mean, ways that normally wouldn't happen, but I think it's been good.
Yeah. Kara, as we get set for our first number, I guess maybe talk about what the show was going to be about, or if it had a theme, or maybe some things leading up to it.
Yeah, so we didn't pick a theme this year. A lot of years the kids will talk about it, but we didn't pick one this year. But we did have a lot of really cool, like, older songs that I was kind of surprised that the kids picked them. So I've been letting the kids in the past couple years pick the songs for the show. And, yeah, I was very surprised. They picked just some, like, oldies but goodies is what I'd call them. That's been a lot of fun.
Carrie's here, so I want to invite her in. Like she's joining. So what is the first number we're going to hear? Actually, before we do that, let me jump in. I'll go back to our seniors first again. Favorite song this year for you guys? Was there one that you were so anxious to be a part of or see performed on stage? Jake?
I really can't think of one off the top of my head. They were all really good this year, especially.
Yeah, very cool. Anna?
I honestly feel the same way. I don't know.
Well, that means it's a great show if you can't pick out one. So that's great. Carrie, welcome, by the way. Thanks for joining us. So now lead us into the first song.
Right. So the first song, this is the one song we had worked on for That's Entertainment that we were ready to start dancing with it when we came back from spring break. And as you know, that didn't happen. So, like I said, this is the song we had down the best, I guess, for That's Entertainment. It's called Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go. So once again, an oldie but a goodie. So what I had the kids do for this is anybody that wanted to was supposed to send me recordings. And so I didn't get recordings from all of the kids, but I got recordings from some of them. So it is not the whole choir, I guess, represented, but the ones that could send it in. So anyway.
Let's hear it. Ladies and gentlemen, Wham's Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go.
Right, and I'll share so you can see the video part too. Great. Is that okay?
Perfect.
Jitterbug. You put the boom boom into my heart. Sing my soul sky high when your loving starts. hit it like it's to my brain. It goes a bang, 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 till my feet do the same. There's something's bugging me, something ain't right. My best friend told me what you did last night. Let me sleep in my bed. I was dreaming, but I should have been with you instead. Wake me up before you go, go. Leave me hanging on like a yo-yo. Wake me up before you go, go. I don't want to miss it when you get that high. Wake me up before you go, go. Cause I'm not planning on going solo. Wake me up before you go, go. Take me dancing tonight. I want to hit that road. To get the gray skies out of my way. You make the sunshine brighter than Doris Day. Turn the bright spark into a flame. Our hearts clapping in the same. You're my lady, I'm your fool. It makes me crazy when you act so cool. Come on, baby, let's not fight. We'll go dancing, everything will be alright. Wake me up before you go, go. Leave me hanging on like a yo-yo. Wake me up before you go, go. I don't want to miss you when you hit that high. Wake me up before you go, go. Cause I'm not planning on going solo. Wake me up before you go, go. Take me dancing tonight. I wanna hit that high. Wake me up. Wake me up before you go, go, go.
Awesome. The crowd went crazy, I'm sure. Good job. Great job. Can't imagine how hard that must be individually to try to. And then a lot of editing, I'm guessing. Late nights, maybe, Kara, putting that together?
Yeah, I actually just finished it about 5 minutes before we started this. I've been working on it a lot. So we did they all sent me their audio, and then we separately recorded the video part through Zoom, and that was sometimes why the lips don't match up is because everyone's internet speed is different. And so just getting everyone's audio edited. And anyway, it was a job.
Very, very cool. Okay, let's go to the terrible trio over there at the Lee establishment. Simon and Isaac and Carson. How many years for you guys in Tiger Chorale? Carson, you're on the left, so your first year, right?
Yes. My first year.
And it's been fun?
So far, yeah.
Yeah? Well,
up until we didn't have the class anymore. But
were you a dancer coming in, or a singer, or both?
Not much of either.
Fair enough.
Probably more so a singer than a dancer, but, you know, we got through it.
Right on. Isaac? Second year. What's that?
Second year.
Second year, okay. You had a highlight of the show last year. I kept people hearing talking about your dance moves. So did you have something planned for this year?
Actually, me and Jake did have a very big surprise planned.
Uh-huh.
We're going to blow the stage away, but fortunately it didn't happen.
Uh-huh. Simon, who?
Concert, but, you okay. know.
What was that, Jake? Say again.
We might have our own concert at a later date. I like it. We're working on planning.
Excellent. Well, let us know so we can all tune in. Simon, talk about being in this group with a brother alongside. You guys ever have any quarrels?
No, I wouldn't say, but At home, maybe, but not in class.
You save it for home?
Yeah.
Okay, very good. Elle, I got you right in the center of my screen, so let's jump over to you. What was the number you were looking forward to? Did you have a solo this year?
I did. I had it one in 9 to 5, which everyone knows that song, so I was excited to sing it.
And you mentioned when we talked Stardusters, the Garth medley that you were part of, right? Was there any numbers that you thought your family would love as much as they would have loved hearing Garth in Stardusters?
Honestly, probably 9 to 5, just because everyone knows Dolly Parton, and that's just kind of that kind of music that we'll listen to at home. So
right, Addie, we'll go to Addie. What was something you were really looking forward to this year?
I was just really looking forward to That's Entertainment and doing like the skits with like each of our section and kind of like figuring out what we were going to do and just dancing and having fun and singing.
Great. Ethan, I know you had some of the ideas behind Stardusters because we just did that a few days ago. And it was the oldie but goodie music again. Did you have any impact on this one?
No, I didn't. I don't really take much of a front stage in Tiger Chorale. I'm just there and I try to bring a good attitude. I didn't do much. A lot of the ideas for the older songs I think were Jake.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Shall we go to another number, Kara?
Sure. So the next one is My Heart Will Go On. So let me share that my screen here with you again. Mm-hmm. And this one we would have done for Stardusters actually. It was all ready to go. So I thought we'd add it as part of this since it was prepared and everything. So here is My Heart Will Go On.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. You guys rocked it again. Carrie, real quickly, Kara was talking about the fact that you were able to be in the room with the class this year. Is that the first time that's happened where you've been able to be with them throughout the year, right?
Yes, first time, and I thought it was really great. It was a bright spot in my day where I could go hang out with them and make some music.
Before you came on, someone mentioned General Stratton. Has that been, you heard that before?
That sounds like someone from the Lee establishment, I think.
It might have been.
Well, some of these kids I got to spend 2 hours a day with because I had a math class and Tiger Chorale. So, you know, we got to be special friends.
Right on. Kara, what if we could go into another song, and I want to come back and talk skits, what if there are ideas already out there, and then maybe we'll have a song and finish with some thoughts on commercials. That'd be okay? So let's go to our next song.
So the next song is the one Ella was talking about. This is 9 to 5. And so Ella has a solo and so does Addie. And we had this song like all ready to go. We were gonna sing it the next week after spring break at Starduster's. So this was actually from Starduster's, but I included it because it was like really polished. So here it is.
Great.
Tumble out of bed and stumble to the kitchen. Pour myself a cup of ambition. Yawn and stretch and try to come to life. Jump in the shower and the blood starts bumping. Out on the street, the traffic starts jumping. With folks like me on the jump from 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living. Petty gets by. You don't take enough giving. You just use your mind. And they never give you any. It's enough to drive you crazy if you want it. Service and devotion, you would think that I would deserve a fair promotion. Want to move ahead, but the boss won't seem to let me. I swear sometimes that man is out to get me.
Just to watch the shatter, you're just a step on the boss man's ladder, but you've got dreams he'll never take away. In the same boat with a lot of your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in, and the tide's gonna turn, and it's all gonna roll your way.
Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, baby. Get it right, it's all taken and no giving, they just use your mind, and they never give you credit. Enough to drive you crazy as a planet. 9 to 5. They got you where they want you. It's a better life. Dream about it, don't you? It's a rich escape. No matter what they call it, you spend your life ruling money and talking. 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taken and no giving, they just use your mind. And they never give no credit, it's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. Take 9 to 5.
Great work, great work, great work. Great work. So let's talk skits. Anyone throw out maybe one that you had an idea for, or was going to happen, had already written one? Anybody?
Well, Isaac and I had a dance planned out, and some others might have joined, but you would have to be there to see it.
It's hard to explain.
I think everyone's trying to imagine, and so that we're going to move on. It might be dangerous to imagine too much of that. Anybody else have a, had you even got to that point of
not
writing?
Really. they had mentioned to me the cowbell skit, like we need more cowbell. Mm-hmm. I don't know if anybody's, if you've seen that before, Rocky.
Absolutely, yes. That's some more old music, though, off of an old Saturday Night Live, actually, which is pretty cool, yeah. Anyone else have had an idea? If not, we're going to hear our final song, if that's okay, Kara. And then had you started in on commercials, or did anyone have ideas on commercials? We won't share them yet, but did you have ideas? It's always a favorite. Maybe?
Yeah, so at this point when we, like, left school, we'd basically learned a few songs. We had our choreographer set up, and when we got back from break, we were supposed to start with the solo auditions for, like, individual, like, so-and-so has their own solo, and right. Then also the skits. So
gotcha.
I know kids were thinking, but we hadn't, like, nailed anything down.
Got it. All right. Well, let's hear a final song.
Yeah, so this song is I Live, and I actually picked this because of what was happening with the coronavirus, and so it was kind of like I just added it in here, and I sent it to all the kids, and they had to learn it on their own without really any help from me. I mean, I had videos to help them, but not, I wasn't like teaching this to them at school, so they did great learning this on their own.
You don't hear the call. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall.
Hope when the ground creeps up, creeping on it. Hope when everybody runs, you choose to stay.
Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. The only way you can know is give all you have.
And I hope that you don't suffer but you take away. Hope when the moment comes you will say,
I swear I live.
Wow. Awesome. The memories that I was not a part of can get to a person, let alone for you guys. I guess Anna and Jake, since you're two seniors that were able to join us today, I'll ask you guys to maybe share favorite part of Tiger Chorale, favorite performance, something that stands out, funny, serious, whatever the case may be. Anna?
My favorite performances would have to be That's Entertainment and like singing the national anthem. I always really enjoyed that. It was pretty special just to do it for our country. And then That's Entertainment because it was just a variety of different music and lots of fun dancing, and you get a chance to have a solo and the skits, of course. Those were always fun. So it was just always a blast.
The national anthem at state basketball, it just hit me that the Lady Tigers realized they weren't going to be back on the court again. You guys didn't have a chance to know that was your last performance either. So you guys did an awesome job first off. But how special was it going in, regardless that it was going to be the last? You didn't know that, but was it like an intense feeling to be a part of a state basketball and to sing the anthem?
Yeah, it was. It was very, it was just like an honor. It's like, oh, they chose us to come and sing. I don't know. And it was just really cool that it fell on the same day that the girls were playing, as Mrs. Bergston had said. It was just kind of a cool coincidence that was meant to happen, I think.
Yeah, for sure. Jake, anything stand out?
I think my favorite part of Tiger Chorale would be this year we got to go on our tour to all the schools. We sing at all the different schools throughout the district. And out of my 3 years, I've only got to do that once due to weather and other stuff. So that was really cool for me this year.
Awesome. Maybe go around our table here and share thoughts on That's Entertainment or on the seniors or thoughts about music. Addie, we'll start with you.
It was my first year being in Tiger Chorale this year, and I was a little nervous at first. But, like, when I walked in the first day, it kind of felt, like, nice. Because I felt, like, really nervous because I'd never sang with these people before. And then we all just sang, like, our first song. And I'll never forget that because it was just a special moment where it just sounded so cool to me. And so that was really special. And to see, like, all these seniors now, like, they just – we're having fun, and it was really inspiring. So just going places with all these people has been really fun. So I'll miss them a lot.
Awesome. Carrie, any thoughts?
Yeah, I don't know if you noticed, Rocky, but this is a vibrant group of students, and they're just, they're so much fun, and you kind of never knew what to expect every day. So one thing I really loved was that even though sometimes it could be a little much, they were so playful. But yet, as soon as the music would start, everyone came together. And it was just, it was beautiful. It was like as much fun as we can have doing, you know, playing around and screwing off sometimes. The music brings us together in a way that's different.
Awesome. Ethan?
Yeah, this was my first year. It was good. I really enjoy being a part of a choir, singing the harmonies and stuff. And it's kind of a, like Mrs. Stratton said, it's a really sort of a laid back feeling. So it's not like this serious, we have to be, you know, professional all the time. It's just a fun thing. But then when you go out and you perform, you know, you do your best and you work with everybody else and trying to make great music, and we do, and it's fun. I liked going places. We had great senior leadership, and that was really great.
Cool.
We're going to miss him.
Ella?
Also my first year, and pretty much just what everyone's been saying is we had some great leaders and seniors this year. And because I've always been a part of music, whether it's choir and band, it was really nice to be a part of a choir that everyone wanted to be there and wanted to sing, and you can just hear the difference when people have, like, passion for it and the music. And We saw a lot of memories on that last video, and there was a lot more that weren't captured, so it was just a lot of fun this year, and I'm definitely glad I get to do it next year again.
How about the comic relief over here? I've heard that mentioned of the Lee brothers and Carson, so what were your thoughts on share what your thoughts are on all this?
One of the things I'm going to remember about Tiger Chorale is Jake Ferguson and his tux. Now, Jake got his tux in his sophomore year and didn't wash it until like 2 days ago.
That's a great memory, Simon. That's a great memory.
My thing that I like from Tiger Chorale is dancing with people, and it's fun.
I'm gonna have to go with Isaac, just like going on stage, just like the practice dancing, just yeah. Not even the performance, but like practicing. It's just fun because you can mess around and you know.
It's hard to tell through Zoom, but I sense some sarcasm here at some point for some reason. I'm not sure why. Kara, any kind of final thoughts on this group, the seniors in general, and this Tiger Chorale?
Yeah, so this year, going into the year, I was really excited because I felt like this group of people really related together well, and I knew that they were all going to be really hard workers. And everyone was going to work as a team. I've had groups in the past that maybe weren't that way, but this group was that way, and I was so excited for this year. And as even though we didn't get to finish it, I think we had some really big moments, like you mentioned, state basketball. We had some really amazing performances, and I just have a lot of really high-quality singers. I try to make Tiger Chorale a class that we can like mess around and have fun, but when it comes down to singing, like we are good and we are serious and we get the job done, and they really showed up. And my seniors, I will miss each and every one of them. They're all special to me in different ways. I have different memories with each one. I remember, for instance, Jake, when he was in eighth grade, I had him in choir, and that poor guy, he was the only boy in this choir class, and somehow I convinced him. And look, he's a great singer now. And Anna, she joined, I think, sophomore year. It was the first time I even had her in class. And right away, she was just an amazing singer at keeping harmony. And she's just a sweetheart in general. So, and that's just the seniors here. I have memories, you know, with so many of them. And I'll miss them so much.
Yeah, seeing the list of them that you put up after the performance, it is a very special group, as all of you are. Incredibly talented. The music that you put together virtually, I said this with band as well, I don't know how that even could happen and sound as brilliant as it did, but you guys did awesome. Thank you guys for sharing your talents, and for the seniors, best of luck. And as I've said to each group, there are so many special students that come through Clay Center, and you guys are certainly a big part of what makes CCCHS incredibly special. Thanks each of you for sharing and being a part and enjoying a virtual That's Entertainment. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Rocky.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See you guys. Thanks.
Yep. Bye-bye.